you've probably noticed that these two bits of content have different styles to them. The heading is bold and it's big. The paragraph is small and it isn't bold. This is simply how the browser is interpreting the tags that we're giving to it. If I go back to our code, we're not really saying anything about how it should look. We're just saying that it is a heading up here, and this part down here is a paragraph. So when we want to have control over how this HTML looks, we're going to use CSS, which stands for Cascading Style Sheets. And we'll talk about what that means a little bit later. Let's go back to our File Explorer and open up the second step, which is called HTML with CSS. Copy this code and paste it over the code that's in your index.html file and save it. Let's go back to the browser and refresh it to see what changed. Okay, so the heading looks a little bit bigger and it has a yellow background. If we jump back to our code, you can see how we're doing that here. So we talked about what a tag was. Within a tag, we can use attributes. The structure of an attribute is the name of the attribute, in this case style, an equal sign, and then quotes around the value. So you see double quotes starting here and ending here. And within that, we'll put the value that this attribute should have. Style allows us to use any CSS property we want in order to give a particular look to this element. So I just use the word element to describe this, and element just describes the tag plus the content that's inside of it. So this element is going to be styled with a background of yellow and a font size of 40 pixels. Now the goal of what we're doing here is just seeing simple HTML and CSS in action, and we will come back and look at how we even knew that we could use an H1 tag or that we could use a background property inside of the style attribute. It's just important to see an example so we have something to build on.